Hey guys, what's going on? I am the Empanada Man. How you guys doing? I'm gonna do something funny today. I'm in my comfort of my home. My wife is holding back right now, but I'm doing this because I'm here to have a good time. I had a little bit too many. I'm gonna disclose that in a few minutes, what it is. But my point is this, I'm here to mix my chicken empanada, my traditional chicken empanada, with a type of fusion, something different. And it's an opportunity that I always wanted to do. So I usually don't have a lot of time, but now that I'm home, chilling with my red Crocs, I'm gonna be doing something funny. So you're gonna see a lot of the red, and you're gonna see a lot of this new product that's out there that the younger crowd are going crazy over. They're going all crazy over this product called Karma Tequila. I met the CEO of this company, one of the founders, and I said, I wanna mix chicken empanada with tequila and bring it together, and let's see if I can pull it off. So we're gonna do this, okay? My eyes are going. All right, look right here. This is that's Karma Tequila. They're from the West Coast. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get this chicken, my traditional chicken empanada. You guys know, as you know, I usually make my empanada with a little spice, chipotle, jalapeno, and I make fresh sofrito. So what happens is, you know what? I have a little olive oil already painted on this. Okay. Now with this on, okay, this carne, this chicken is already marinated and ready to go. The only difference here is that I'm gonna add Mr. Karma to this. Okay. All right. How do we add Karma to this? Real simple. You get a little Karma shot glass. Okay. Alright, see, I don't have to be sexy, I don't have to be correct, because I'm not on Food Network, I'm in my own network. Okay, first of all, we're going to do a little bit of shot, okay? And we're also going to add a little lime to it, okay? What's tequila without lime, right? Alright, look at that, huh? Look at the dressing on that. And the leftover, you should always finish it. Ooh. Meanwhile, while this is getting sauteed, okay, the Karma Tequila, over here, the oil is getting cooked, getting ready. Now, the hard part about the empanada is the inserting. Inserting food into dough is not the easiest thing. That's why I'm in business. I do something that most people don't want to do. They love empanadas, but nobody wants to make them. That's how I got in. So, what we do is, traditionally, this is what people do. They get a dough disc anywhere at a supermarket, and people use this. Now, people think that I did the empanada business 8 years ago with a fork. I never did. I found the mold at a local store and started doing it that way. And let me tell you, it wasn't the easiest thing, okay? Put a little yolk around it, okay? Now, as you guys can see, I'm in my kitchen. I'm in my comfort zone. So I don't use jewelry when I cook, okay? I'm just doing this to impress my sister-in-law, who's nuts over me, okay? So, all right? Now, the chicken is done, okay? Now, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put a good 2 ounces of chicken empanada that's already sauteed in lime and Karma, okay? And then I'm gonna close it with my juggernaut fingers, okay? Now most people are gonna have trouble with this if you're not strong. The problem with this product is that it only closes 80% of the time versus the machine that I use that is not disclosed because it's top secret. But I apply the juggernaut. Oops, the juggernaut press. Look at that. You see, when you screw up, you can even still fix it. That's the beauty of dough. Okay? Now I make thousands of these. Obviously you can tell that I don't do it by hand anymore. Okay. I do it by hand, but it's semi-automatic, not a gun. All right, here you go. This is going into the deep fryer. Okay. Now, as this is getting cooked, nice. The chicken's already cooked inside, so you have the option either deep fry it or put it in an oven pan and dress it up with oil. And do it that way if you're more health conscious. If you're like me, or you're all into clogging up arteries, I'm the guy. This is the way I do it. I deep fry everything, you know? You put it, in here, you give it less than 4 minutes. If it's already thawed out, just deep fry it real quick and it's done. Just all you gotta do is make sure you get a somewhere to drain the oil, okay? You gotta look at that. That's what I'm talking about. Without that, you can't cook. You need those. Okay? I should be getting royalties from Crocs, you know that. Alright. We're almost done here. Okay, now I'm gonna go in here.
I'm so drunk.
Okay, hold on. I got more time. Here. This is what I do. Your karma, you mix it with like anime and pollo, and you put it inside the dough, and then you deep fry it, and that's it. You're done. And you do that. Mm. Oh my gosh. Somebody, we need a babysitter. Okay, here you go. Get it out. Look at that. That's what I'm talking about. Alright. As you can see, the empanada is over and done. Soak it up. Bring it here. We're gonna wrap it up real quick here. Okay? Insert. Remember that little mistake I did? You can't even tell. I'm glad I did that. I'm not here to perfect anything. We're just here to have a good time. Cut it up in half. Okay? Here you go. You got my chicken empanada from J&J Empanada. Okay? Sauteed in karma tequila, 100% agave. Alright? These guys from the West Coast are making an incredible tequila. And I'm just nuts over this, so let me try it out right now in front of you guys. Tequila. Mm-hmm. This is good. Mmm. Man, this is good. I think Karma should be calling me any minute. You want some of this empanada? You can have this. Basically, my empanada will be cut like that for you, and then sauteed with karma tequila, and you can do it yourself. Mm. Place your order. This is delicious. Bye-bye.